Hello friends, welcome to our channel Piping Mantra. Today we are going to discuss about pipe thickness, that is how to calculate it, its importance, affecting factors, etc. So let's get started. At first, we need to know exactly what a pipe is. So in layman terms, we all know pipe is a hollow tube with round cross section for the conveyance of products like fluids, gas, pellets, powders and more. Which is almost true. A pipe is a pressure tight cylinder used to transport fluids. Now, one might wonder what is the difference between a pipe and a tube, but there is in fact a difference between the two. Let's see how. The main difference lies between their thickness and the way of defining them. That is, pipe is defined on the basis of nominal pipe size, that is NPS, and thickness as schedule, whereas tubes are defined on the basis of outside diameter OD and thickness in mm. In simple terms, pipe is defined by its internal diameter, that is ID, and tube by its outside diameter, that is OD. Since the difference between the two terms is clear, let us go through the history of pipe thickness or schedule number before discussing the method to calculate it. So, at the IPS, that is iron pipe size time, only three wall thicknesses were in use, which were STD, that is standard, XS, extra strong, and XXS, that is double extra strong. Later, the American Standard Association surveyed industry and created a system that designated wall thicknesses based on smaller steps between sizes. The designation known as nominal pipe size replaced iron pipe size, and the term schedule SCH was invented to specify the nominal wall thickness of pipe. By adding schedule numbers to the IPS standards, today we know a range of wall thicknesses. In these schedule numbers, the S adjacent to a number indicates for SS pipe. That is, 40 is for schedule number for carbon steel and 40S is schedule number for SS pipe. So basically, pipe size is specified with two non-dimensional numbers, which are NPS, nominal pipe size, and schedule number SCH. For a given NPS, the outside diameter stays constant and the wall thickness increases with larger schedule number. The inside diameter will depend upon the pipe wall thickness specified by the schedule number. And the relationship between these numbers determine the inside diameter of a pipe. Once the inside diameter, that is ID, of the pipe segment has been determined, the pipe wall thickness must be calculated. There are many factors that affect the pipe wall thickness requirement, which include the maximum and working pressures, maximum and working temperatures, chemical properties of the fluid velocity, the pipe material and grade, the safety factor or code design application. Now, for calculation part, there are three conditions under which thickness can be calculated. First, thickness of straight pipe under internal pressure. Second, thickness of straight pipe under external pressure. And third is thickness of bend. Let's see how we can calculate the first portion, that is thickness of straight pipe under internal pressure. As per ASME B31.3, the process piping code in clause 304.1.1 gives minimum thickness as follows. TM is equal to T plus C, where T is equal to PD by 2 of SC plus PY, and C is C1 plus C2, where P is internal design gauge pressure, D is outside pipe diameter, S is allowable stress, E is joint quality factor, Y is coefficient. C1 is corrosion allowance, which is equals to 1.6 mm in general for carbon steel and 0 mm for stainless steel. C2 is depth of thread. Particular parameter of C2 is used only up to 1.5 inches of nominal pipe. Now, the thickness calculated through above formula has to be corrected to consider the mill tolerance of minus 12.5%. So, our final formula becomes TM is equals to PD plus 2 SCY plus PY plus C1 plus C2 into 8 by 7. We can consider some values of these terms like S, E, Y and C1 from the attached table or pictures as you can see on your screens, and value of D, which is outside diameter, can also be found with the chart. You know what? Let's try to understand it better through an example. So the example says, a 12-inch, that is 300mm NB pipe, has an internal maximum operating pressure of 500 psig and temperature of 675 degree Fahrenheit. The material of construction of the pipe is seamless carbon steel to ASTM A106GRB. The recommended corrosion allowance is 1 by 8 inches, that is 3mm. Calculate the thickness of pipe as per ASME B31.3 and select the proper schedule. In this case, we are, without wasting any of our time, we are going to directly use the formula. For P, let's suppose the design pressure is 10% more than the maximum operating pressure. So P will be 1.1 into 500, that is 550 psig. We can take more than 10% also, but that will lead to more thickness of pipe, components, more weights, etc. So we are going for 550 psig only. Now D is 12.75 inches, OD of 12 NB pipe. Is equals to 3 to 3.9 mm. Since temperature is more than 650 degree Fahrenheit, we are going to consider the next higher value of 700 degree Fahrenheit. Accordingly, allowable stress from the table for ASTM A106GRB at 700 degree Fahrenheit, S is equals to 16700 psi. Now, E is equals to 1, Y is equals to 0.4. These values can be calculated or derived from the tables given. C1 is equals to 0.125 inches, that is 3 mm. This is a given value. And C2 is equals to 0 since the line is greater than 2 inches. So now let's calculate TM. As you can see on your screen, TM is equals to 550 into 12.75 divided by 2 into 16700 into 1 plus 550 into 0.4 plus 0.125. which becomes 7012.5 by 33840 is equals to 0.3322, and the final result is 0.3322 inches, that is 9.64 mm. Now to calculate the schedule number, we are going to refer the table displayed on your screen. Since the OD or NPS is 12 inches, for schedule STD, the thickness is 9.53, which is less than our calculated value. And for schedule 40, the thickness is 10.31, which is greater than our calculated value. We will be considering pipe with schedule 40 as it has nominal pipe thickness of 0.406 inches and minimum of 0.355 inches. We are always going to take the higher value. I hope this is clear now. We are now going to discuss thickness of straight pipe under external pressure. So, we are considering pipe as a vessel in thickness calculation of straight pipe under external pressure. As we all know, diameter to thickness ratio of a vessel is very high, due to which it can collapse under external pressure loads. So, a nominal wall thickness is provided to prevent phenomena like buckling and excessive compressive forces. To determine wall thickness and stiffening requirements for straight pipe under external pressure, the procedure outlined in the BPV code section 8, division 1, UG 28 through UG 30 shall be followed. The value of S to be used in determining allowable P shall be A is 1.5 times the stress value from table A1 or table A1M of this code, ASME B31.3. B is 0.9 times yield strength tabulated in section 2, part D, table Y1 for materials listed therein. Now the formula for calculating allowable pressure is 4 by 3 B by D0 by T. However, to know the value of B, we should know the value of A from graph G, which is given under the same code, that is ASME B31.3. From the graph, we can calculate or derive the value of A, which further depends upon the ratio of L by D and D by T. We can refer to the graph to determine what thickness should be considered for what pressure value based on temperature and material. Here, we will do reverse calculation. For the calculation part, it is done backwards. That is, first a thickness is assumed and then the corresponding pressure is calculated. Let's see how through an example. A 6 inches, that is 150 mm NB pipe, has an external design pressure of 400 psig at 750 degree Fahrenheit. The material of construction of pipe is seamless austenitic stainless steel to ASTM A312TP304L. The corrosion allowance is nil. Calculate thickness and select proper schedule. For this,
First, we are going to assume the value of t to determine the value of L by D0 and D0 by t. D0 for 6 inches NB pipe is 6.625 inches. Assume schedule 5 as pipe. So, nominal thickness corresponding to schedule 5 as pipe is 0.109 inches. Minimum thickness considering negative middle tolerance of 12.5%. So, T becomes 0.875 into 0.109, that is 0.095 inches. Now consider L by D0 is equal to 50, since L is unspecified. So, D0 by T becomes 6.625 by 0.095, which becomes 69.7. Now, from graph G and HA3, the value of factor A and B at 750 Fahrenheit are 0.000225 and 2750 respectively. Therefore, allowable pressure PA becomes 4 by 3 into B by D0 by T, which is 4 into 2750 by 3 into 69.7. So, our PA is 52.6 PSIG. This is less than the value of design pressure given. Therefore, we are assuming a higher thickness value, that is 80S pipe, which gives us the nominal thickness of 0.432 inches. Minimum thickness is 0.875 into 0.432, which becomes 0.378 inches. Now, the D0 by T value is 17.5. The factor A for the new value of D0 by T is 0.0038. Corresponding value of factor B is 5500. So, the allowable pressure becomes 419 PSIG, which is more than our design pressure given. So, we are selecting 80S schedule pipe.
Let's move on to thickness of bend. I'm not going to explain this in detail as in that case, it will take me more time. So, briefly, the minimum TM or thickness of bend is PD by 2 SEW by I plus PY, and at introduce I is 4 R1 by D minus 1 by 4 R1 by D minus 2. Whereas at extra dose, I is equals to 4 R1 by D plus 1 by 4 R1 by D plus 2. In general, I is equals to 1 and the thickness apply at mid span, that is Y by 2. Now, the reason behind which we are considering only the ASME standard is ASME standard B31.3 is more conservative than either standard B31.4 or B31.8, especially relative to API 5L. X-grade pipe and electrical resistance welded, that is ERW seam pipe. The cost associated with the standard B31.3 piping design may be substantial compared to the other codes and may not be necessarily, especially for onshore facilities. At this note, I am wrapping up this video. See you next time with a new video on something new to learn. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, comment, subscribe and press the bell icon to get all the notifications. And if you want us to prepare a video on some other certain topics, let us know in the comment section below. Thank you so much.